Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and today we're going to talk about 70-489, which is developing Microsoft SharePoint Server 2013 Advanced Solutions. And with me again is Christopher Harrison, who's an MCT.
Yeah, Microsoft Certified Trainer based out of San Diego. Been a trainer now for about the past 14 years and been doing SharePoint really since 2007, both on the admin side as well as on the dev side.
So, Christopher, this is the second exam in the MCSD for SharePoint applications.
Correct.
And this one is called Advanced.
That is correct.
What does that mean?
That's a great question. Advanced, for our purposes, for this exam, certainly does have a little bit of advanced parts to it, that there is going to be a little bit more tuning, kind of things that I would expect a senior developer to know about doing SharePoint development. But in particular, the biggest thing that you're going to notice about this exam, as opposed to the core exam, is it's a lot of SharePoint server features. So when you start talking about things like managed metadata, you start talking about things like the social capabilities, you start talking about things like search, all of that is SharePoint Server. And so that's really the biggest difference between these two exams. You'll notice there's not a whole lot of overlap. I mean, there's certainly enough product inside of SharePoint to have two and maybe even three exams. But that's going to be the split, really, that when you stop and take a look at it, that for the most part, outside of BCS, that it's SharePoint Server on the advanced side and then SharePoint Foundation on the core side.
So you mentioned BCS. Let's start with that.
Yep.
Why do we call that out on its own?
Well, the reason that we call that out, and for those of you not familiar, BCS stands for Business Connectivity Services. And it's a great way to incorporate external data into your SharePoint environment. Because after all, when you deploy SharePoint out and you do it properly, it very quickly becomes the entry point to any data, regardless of where that is. SharePoint's not a database, so I don't want database data inside of there. But if I do have external data, I'd like it to appear as if it's inside of SharePoint. And there's a lot of neat things that we can now do with BCS, like creating my own code. So maybe we've got kind of our own layer that's going to go off to a database, pull the data in that way. We also now have the ability with 2013 to even be able to execute event receivers when something changes behind the scenes in that external data. So if you are going to deploy out BCS, chances are you're going to be doing some level of development. And quite frankly, if you're deploying out SharePoint, chances are you're also going to be doing BCS. That's why it's there on the exam.
Okay. So unless you've been living under a rock, social media is huge these days.
It absolutely is.
What does a developer need to keep in mind when he's writing applications in SharePoint around social media?
So probably the number one biggest change that your users will notice in SharePoint is that social media, that social networking, that it's just now everywhere, that you get these little chat boxes everywhere, you can have news feeds everywhere, people can tag items. And so when I'm going in and I'm creating my own custom apps, I'm creating my own custom components, my own custom features, I want to incorporate all of that as well. Because, you know, if I've got a newsfeed over here and I've got a newsfeed over here, if I go in and I create my own app, and that capability is not available, my users aren't going to be as happy with that. That having those social capabilities really allows for that more informal, that more real-time communication. So I want to be able to incorporate that. And so that's why it's there. So as a developer, if I am going to be creating my apps, I am going to be needing to integrate that into those applications.
Okay. You know, another thing that we call out is MMS.
Yes.
If the users are just going to fire up IE and input terms, why do we test on that?
That's a great question. So MMS, or Managed Metadata Services, gives me the ability to centralize certain terms, certain keywords. So that way, when it comes to things like location or job titles, where, you know, maybe people don't necessarily know what their job title is, or they might have a job title, but that also has an abbreviation. If they go in and they start tagging items on their own, and they start putting in the abbreviation, and some people put in the full name, trying to search for that or categorize that later really becomes a challenge. So that's where MMS comes into play. And you are absolutely right that people can just fire up IE and go ahead and have at it. Well, again, if I'm going to be creating my own custom applications, mm-hmm. I want to make sure that if we have job titles stored somewhere, that I can pull that in, that if I'm creating my own custom interface, or maybe I'm going to be deploying out an app that I know is going to be in a lot of different spots, and I want to make sure that the terminology that's going to be used is going to be the same, I may need to programmatically set up that term group, that term store behind the scenes mm-hmm. to allow people to have that consistent value. So that's why you may find yourself using that with the API rather than just doing that through through the browser. And I would also mention with 2013 that there's now a lot of client-side tools that are available for doing that, client-side APIs, and even through JavaScript, which wasn't available in 2010.
Okay. Let's wrap up with search, because search is something that's, again, really popular these days.
Yep.
With the fast acquisition that Microsoft did a few years ago, yep. and all that's sort of been integrated into SharePoint.
Mm-hmm.
So what do developers have to think about?
So what Fast does, or what Fast did, I guess is kind of a better way to put it now, is it really took SharePoint search and it just took it up to that next level. And it gave me a lot of additional capabilities that I didn't have. It gave me a lot more control over the results the users were eventually going to see. It, of course, was faster. Mm-hmm. Wasn't just a clever name. And it also gave me the ability to go in and clean up items. And this is actually one of the biggest features that came forward into 2013, and it's something that does require a developer. When you implement search, search isn't just searching inside of SharePoint, that I'm going to have maybe data inside of a database, I'm going to have data inside of a file share. If the data is inside of SharePoint, when it comes to that metadata, those keywords that people are going to flag their items with and then later search on, there's a lot that I can do in SharePoint to clean that up, to make okay. sure that that's consistent. If it's in a file share, I don't necessarily have that capability. So people could be using different abbreviations, they could be using different terms, or maybe there's like a little bit of a lookup. So maybe something is flagged with, say, an email address. Mm-hmm. And what I want to do is be able to search for that item based on the person's name, not just their email address. So one of the capabilities that we had with Fast and now inside of SharePoint server search with 2013 is the ability to write our own code to actually grab the items as they come in through the pipeline, go in, grab the certain attribute that we're interested in, maybe that email address, execute a little bit of code behind the scenes, go look up what the name is, and add that to the metadata that's going to be stored inside of the SharePoint search index. So you'll notice that if you're looking for those advanced features like the one that I just mentioned there, yeah. you've got to be writing code for that.
Well, thanks, Christopher, for being here. We really appreciate it.
Well, thanks for having me. I'm glad to be here.
So we've been talking about 70-489, which is developing Microsoft SharePoint Server 2013 Advanced Solutions, and it's the second exam in the SharePoint Applications MCSD. So go out, get certified, and write some applications.
Go get them.